United States helps enhance health services in Ethiopia. During the last 5 years, the United States Agency for International Development, or the USAID, has worked in collaboration with the Ethiopian Ministry of Health to provide improved medical care to 2.5 million households. USAID has supported the training of over 2,500 health professionals to assist people in 50 cities and towns throughout Ethiopia. Furthermore, Ethiopia's urban citizens have benefited from the provision of safe drinking water and improved hygiene and sanitation. With the yearly contributions of approximately $200 million, the United States is the top supporter of the nation's healthcare sector. We gratefully treasure your considerate assistance, USAID, and God bless you. May peace-loving Ethiopian citizens continue with improved health and harmonious and elevating progress in heaven's protecting embrace.
Saudi Arabia uses 3D technology to print a house. The National Housing and Industrial Development and Logistics Program of Saudi Arabia has announced the kingdom's first 3D printed house. Situated on housing ministry land in the capital city of Riyadh and printed by Dutch company Saibi, the house was created by a robotic arm which sets down layers of cement on top of each other. It prints the hollow walls according to the 3D design inputted into the computer it is connected to. The new technology will save on the labor costs of construction, thus making housing more affordable for citizens. Our earnest appreciation, Saudi Arabia, for your dedication to using technology to support the people of your nation. May your kind citizens flourish evermore in Allah's grace.
Scientists discover efficient ways to extract energy from sewage. In a new paper published in the Frontiers in Energy Research Journal, scientists from Spain describe the use of purple phototrophic bacteria to extract energy from domestic and industrial wastewater. The researchers were able to supply the bacteria with electrons, which modify their metabolisms to cause the bacteria to behave in various ways. Depending on their environmental conditions and the electric current supplied, the bacteria can be used to create hydrogen gas, a biodegradable polyester, or proteins. By capturing carbon dioxide as part of their process, the bacteria also create a new way to reduce carbon dioxide emissions. The research will continue to optimize the processes further. Amazing Spanish scientists, congratulations on your new discovery. May your future research be successful as you work towards creating a more pristine and green world.
Reverse vending machines help reduce litter in picturesque seaside towns in Australia. Since December 1, 2017, the government of New South Wales, Australia, has deployed 800 reverse vending machines. The devices return 10 cents for every eligible deposited recycled can or bottle made of glass, plastic, steel, aluminium, or carton. There has been a significant reduction of plastic rubbish found in coastal waters since the plan was implemented. With over 1 billion containers having already been recycled throughout New South Wales, it is envisioned the scheme can reduce litter in the state by 40% by 2020. Way to go, New South Wales Government, for taking care of the environment while creating a great way to earn a bit of money. May you meet your goals and more as we all join the effort to clean up our lovely planet.
Canada to accept 350,000 new citizens by 2021. Canada will increase the number of immigrants accepted into the country with a plan to welcome 350,000 people by 2021. The new citizens will consist of refugees as well as individuals accepted under economic programs with skills that are needed in the current job market. Newcomers will be taken care of by the government to ensure they have adequate access to housing and services and opportunities to integrate into their host communities. As part of Canada's commitment to refugees, funds have been allocated to welcome 1,000 vulnerable women and girl refugees over the coming 2 years. As always, a heartfelt gratitude, Canada, for your welcoming and compassionate actions and for sharing your beautiful land with the world. May heaven bless your vast nation as you continue to prosper and be a beacon of hope for those in need, in God's love.
Corn opens world's largest meatless and vegan product factory. Meat-free food company Corn has opened the largest vegan and meatless factory in the world in Billingham, United Kingdom. Their current factory has now reached full capacity, and the new £27 million site is expected to produce 1.33 million packs of corn per week, or 20,000 metric tons annually. With a growth rate of 15% per year, the company has invested £150 million in its expansion, which include plans to develop new vegan products and a goal of being worth $1 billion by 2027. Congratulations, Corn, on your rapid growth and the successful opening of your new factory. May vegan companies spring up in every corner of our globe as world citizens embrace good health, compassion, and sustainability.
World commemorates International Snow Leopard Day. Countries around the globe celebrated International Snow Leopard Day. An occasion started in 2013 when the Bishkek Declaration on the Conservation of the Snow Leopard was signed by 12 snow leopard range nations. Annual events serve as a reminder that the vulnerable snow leopard is an irreplaceable natural and cultural symbol, an indicator of the sustainability and health of high mountain ecosystems, and should be protected from threats brought about by climate change and poaching. In Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia's capital, the World Wildlife Fund Mongolia and environmental officers celebrated the day amid dance and art performances presented by children. Likewise, Bhutan exhibited 50 artworks at its Royal Textile Academy, while Pakistan screened the documentary Science Society and Snow Leopards. We are very touched by the collective efforts to safeguard the snow leopard. May we protect our exquisite ecosystems and biodiversity on Earth in divine grace.